Good morning to all. I am Professor Navneet Kaur from Department of Electronics and Communication and Sagar Institute of Research and Technology College. Today I'll discuss the lab practicals of subject Digital Signal Processing EC601. First, we will discuss the list of experiments. The first practical is write a MATLAB program to plot real and complex exponential sequences. In this subject, the software which we are using for plotting and performing the experiment is MATLAB software. So all the practicals will be done on MATLAB software. The second practical is write a MATLAB program to plot impulse response of first order and second order discrete time system. Third is write a MATLAB program to find and plot even and odd components of a signal. The fourth experiment is write a program to compute and plot linear convolution of two signals. Fifth practical is write a program to compute and plot circular convolution of two signals. The sixth practical which we'll be doing will be write a program to compute DFT of a given signal and plot amplitude and phase spectrum. Seventh practical is write a program to compute Fourier coefficients of a given signal and sketch its amplitude and phase spectrum. Eighth practical is write a program to design Butterworth IIR low pass filter. Ninth practical is write a program to design Chebyshev IIR low pass filter, and in a last practical is the write a program to design FIR filter using window technique. Now firstly I'll discuss my first experiment, which is write a program to plot real and complex exponential sequence. I have already discussed that the software which I'll be using for performing of experiments is MATLAB. First, I have discussed theory here. I have given the expression for discrete time complex exponential. Now, since we are using discrete time signal, so here the time parameter used is n. And the exponential signal is given by a e raised to power sn, where s is, say, it has real part as well as imaginary part. This s can be real only or it can be imaginary also. Here I am writing s as sigma plus iota omega because I want to plot both real and complex exponential here. So e raised to power iota omega n is expressed as e raised to power iota omega plus 2 pi n. This expression signifies that when we are using complex exponential, this complex exponential is periodic because it repeats itself after a period of 2 pi. Now, coming to Euler's formula, which we already know that when we are having complex exponential, it can be expressed in the form of cos and sine, which is written as cos x plus j sine x. Now I'll discuss the program code which we run on MATLAB software. Now since we are plotting discrete time signal, so first parameter which I'll define here is n. N I am taking range from 0 to 25 with an interval of 1. Why I have taken interval of 1? Because in discrete time signals the samples are specified at integer value of n. That is n at 0, 1, 2, 3. We can take negative values of n also, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on. Now first we are plotting real exponential signal. So real exponential signal is expressed by exp syntax. So y is equal to exp and 0.2 into n. That means this expression is y is equal to e raised to power 0.2 n. Now I'll be plotting. Now, since we will be plotting more than one graph on a figure window, so to make it easy, I'll be using command subplot, and the parameters specified in subplot are 3, 1, 1. 3, 1 means in this figure window there are 3 rows and 1 column. So 3 rows, 1 column, that means 3 graphs can be accommodated in a figure window. And this particular graph will be accommodated in first place. And step command is used for plotting discrete time signals, right? So step n means the parameter which I'll be taking on x-axis. So on x-axis I'll be using parameter of time, which is n, comma y means the value of the expression. Now, to make the signal more expressive, I'll be adding labels to x and y axis, and for that I'll use x label and y label. X label n and y label is yn, and I'll give title real exponential sequence. Now, after this real exponential, I'll be plotting complex exponential sequence. Now, in this complex exponential sequence, same I'll take n from 0 to 50, but y I have taken exp, and I have here multiplied I. I is imaginary term, so here I have imaginary exponential or complex exponential. So, for plotting this, I'll take subplot. 3, 1, now I have taken 2, that means this graph will be placed on second position. So stem n, y, for labeling x label n, y label, I have given this signal say name zn, and title will be complex exponential sequence. Now I'll be plotting exponential signal which will be having both real part as well as complex part. So y is equal to exponential 0.1n plus iota 0.2n. So I'll be taking subplot 3, 1, 3. So this graph will be on the third place. Stem n, y, x label n, y label cn. This graph is represented by cn, and title I'll give real n complex exponential sequence. When I'll run this MATLAB program, so I'll get 3 graphs. First is for real exponential sequence. Second graph is for complex exponential sequence, and third graph is for real and complex exponential sequence. So here I can see that real exponential sequence graph is non-periodic, whereas complex exponential sequence is periodic signal. So this is all about my first experiment. So now I end my session.